Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 73 of our Golang course. In this lesson, we will cover the cond object, or a short name for condition. I'm just going to refer it as condition throughout the lesson. Usually, it is recommended to use channels most of the time, but there are times when channels are insufficient to do the job of conditions. So, let's get started and understand when and where condition should be used. Condition is used to transmit signals between two goroutines. Think of it as a waiting room where goroutines can sleep until a specific event occurs. Please note that condition don't provide any information or data. It's just a signal telling you something has happened. To understand more about condition, let us see what Go docs for condition say. They say, condition implements a condition variable, a point for goroutine waiting for a or announcing the occurrence of an event. To put it simply, it is a signal that indicates the occurrence of a condition being met. So why exactly we need condition? If we were to think of ways to implement it, the naive approach would be to start an infinite loop and check if the condition was met on every loop iteration. This is a very performance intensive approach. Instead, wouldn't it be better if we could create a background goroutine that does nothing until this condition is met? So basically, the goroutine is sleeping until the condition is met, and when the condition is met, we wake the goroutine up to perform the task it was assigned. This is exactly what condition help us achieve. Let us go over fields and method of condition. This is an associated locker, usually sync.mutex or sync.readWriteMutex. The lock must be held when changing the condition or calling the wait method. Then we have the wait method. This causes the calling routine to block until another goroutine signals the condition or that the condition has been met. Then we have signal, which wakes up one goroutine blocked on the condition. Then we have the broadcast. Broadcast wakes up all goroutine blocked on the condition. So, locker is the interface locker. It is used to work with condition. The wait is something that the consumer has to use to wait for the condition to occur. Then we have two methods, signal and broadcast, which are used on the producer side to signal that a condition has been met. The difference between signal and broadcast is that signal only is used to wake up one goroutine, while broadcast can be used to wake up multiple goroutines. This is where you would use condition, because the job of signal can be implemented with channels, that is, when you only want to wake up a single goroutine and ask it to start working. Implementing broadcast with channel is not easy, and in code, you will see condition is used when there is a need of broadcast. Now let us look at an code example for the same. So in this example, let us first create the condition variable. It is going to be a package level condition variable. Sync.newCondition and pass the mutex, for which we are just going to use a simple mutex. Then let us create a integer skew. Var integers, so a slice of int values, length 0 and capacity of 10. Now let us create a remove function. So here is our remove function. What we are doing is we are accepting a delay of time.duration type. We sleep for that time, and then we are just printing a statement which says length of integers before removing. Then we are removing the first element or from the front of the slice. Then we are printing the length after removing. Then we are calling condition.signal to signal that an element has been removed from the slice. This is because we are going to maintain a queue of length 2 and 2 only, so that at one point of time, there are only going to be at max 2 elements in the integer slice. Now let's write the add function. So in the add function, what we are doing is we are starting a loop and we iterate over 5 times. Inside it, first we are holding the lock, then we are checking for the length, which is the condition that we are going to wait around. So if length is equal to 2, then we wait. After that, we are just printing length before adding. So when we are signaling here, it will wake up from here and check the length again. If it's 2, it sleeps again. On the next call to signal, this goroutine will wake up again and then check again. If the length is not is equal to 2, it will go on and append to the integer values, printing length after adding. Then To simulate this cycle, we are just calling remove with 1 second delay in a new goroutine. And finally, we are calling condition l.unlock to unlock the locker on the condition. So the gist of this code is that here we are waiting on a condition which is length of integers is equal to 2. And if it's true, we wait. Otherwise, we add and then remove after a delay of 1 second. Here, let's call this go add. So we are starting a new routine to call add. Then we are just going to sleep. Let's say 5 seconds, 5 into time.seconds. Now let's run our program to see what happens. So as you can see, length after adding is 2. This time, this condition is satisfied. So we wait for the element to be removed. So we get length before removing is 2. Length after removing is 1. Now, since length is 1, we can wake up from here, check again. This is not true, so we proceed ahead with this again. And as such, the cycle continues. Whenever the length is lower than 2, we add an element. And if it goes greater than 2, this coroutine is called and we remove an element for the next element to be added. So that's basically how you would use a condition variable. To revise again, here we are the producer in remove. We take a delay to simulate some work. Then we do time.sleep for the delay, remove the first element from the integer slice, and then signal any waiting goroutine. Here you can also use broadcast to indicate to multiple goroutines that a condition has been met. Inside that, we are just running a loop 5 times, holding the lock first, and then this is our condition we are waiting for. We check the condition. If it's true, we wait. So whenever broadcast is called, this coroutine will wake up from here, check again. If this condition is true, it will sleep again. If not, we proceed ahead to append integer to the integer slice. And at the same time, we also call remove with a delay of 1 second, finally unlocking. So that's basically how you would use the condition. Let's summarize everything we have learned in this lesson. First, we looked at condition, which is a way of indicating that a condition has been met. Condition is mainly used for broadcast, that is to indicate to multiple goroutines that a condition has been met. Usually, as I mentioned before, channels are recommended when you only want to signal a single goroutine waiting for your action. But if there are multiple goroutines waiting for action, you are good to use conditions. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!